Hi YouTube, Tim Unkert here. In this video, we're going to install the OpenShot video editor on a Chromebook, so let's get to it. The first thing we need to do is install the Linux development environment. I'll go down to my launcher, click on that, and search for settings. I'm then going to open up my settings, and on the left-hand side, I'm going to go down to the bottom where you have About Chrome OS. Once I click on that, I see I have this Linux development environment. I'll click Setup. And then I'm going to click Next. Once the wizard comes up, you'll have a username, which is based off your email. You may want to change that right now, because I don't think you'll be able to change that in the future. The disk size you can change in the future. I'm going to give it a little bit extra here. So I'm going to go up to, let's go up to say about 25 gigabytes here. And I'll click Install. That's going to take a few moments, so I'll let that run through and come on back. Okay, once the Linux development environment installs, this terminal will pop up. You can close out the settings at this point. I'm just going to make this a little bit larger so you can see what I'm doing. And we're going to make sure everything is up to date by typing sudo apt update, and then two ampersands sudo apt upgrade, and I'm going to do a dash y flag here. The dash y flag will just keep me from answering yes to any additional space the upgrade will take. And I'm going to let that run through and I'll come on back. Okay, one other thing, I'm going to pin this here just because we will be using the terminal to start up OpenShot. The other thing is I want to install a couple dependencies because we'll be using OpenShot as an app image. And so those dependencies are Fuse and libfuse2. To install those, we'll type sudo apt install fuse and then space libfuse2. Hit enter. It's going to take a little bit of extra space. I'll say yes. Okay, and then we want to go and open up our browser here and we want to search for OpenShot. And we'll go to their webpage, openshot.org. Click on that, go to the downloads, and we want to do the Linux downloads, and it's an app image. We'll download that. Okay, once that's downloaded, let's click open our downloads folder, and you'll see I've downloaded it twice. I'm just going to copy it into my Linux files, so let's just paste it into there. Okay, once it's in there, we can close that out. We can close this out. Let's go back to our terminal here. Let's clear everything out. And let's do ls to list out what we have in our directory. So we want to make this file executable. So to do that, we'll type chmod and then a plus x, a period, forward slash, and I'll start to type OpenShot and then hit tab to autocomplete. Hit enter. Now it's executable, so we can open it. Period, forward slash, and then start to type OpenShot, hit tab to autocomplete, and we can enter it up. And it's going to now start up. Okay, so let's just minimize the terminal here. So now we've got OpenShot opened up. I'm going to hide the tutorial and we can get some videos and start editing in OpenShot. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you did, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.